Good morning, folks. Out of the woods. Starting to rain again. Today, let's talk about the most important pieces of gear, of the unimportant pieces. The sleeping bag. Do you need a sleeping bag on the Camino? So, first of all, I think we must let go of the word need. What do you need? You need something to protect your feet. You need something that keeps you warm. You need something to carry your stuff with you. That's it. Everything else is a matter of luxury. Some people are on the way with a cotton sleeping bag. Others, like a friend of mine, with a fleece blanket. Others with a 2 kilo piece of mummy sleeping bag, polar proofed. And others with nothing at all. They trust that they can have a blanket at the albergue. And yes, I know, there's many manufacturers that produce many good stuff, different brands, and I can only tell you my own experiences with the stuff that I bought from my own money. Hence, this is no advertisement, that's nothing, that's just my own opinion. And I will go on like this until I get sponsored by a manufacturer or retailer. But until then, we go on like this. When I buy something for hiking or now for the Camino, I select my stuff by weight, size, functionality, and price. So, just to pick up the word need, do I need a sleeping bag? Let's say the average pilgrim walking the Camino from spring to fall or autumn, and no, you don't need a sleeping bag, but it's much more comfortable than without one. What you definitely do not need is a mummy sleeping bag down to minus 10 degrees Celsius with a hood. No, for what? Another thing that you do not need is a thermarest. For what? Unless you do not want to sleep outside in an abandoned house on the floor, or if you go camping with your tent. No, what you want to do with that? Put on the mattress? Why? Walking the Camino is all about leaving all the things at home that you do not need. And if you should find out that you need something and you didn't take with you, gosh, you're not on the PCT in the wilderness fighting with bears. Almost every day you walk through cities. People in Spain is prepared for the pilgrims. You can buy stuff there, no problem. So when you want to sleep at the albergue, and I think in most of the time that's the case, you will find a mattress, some kind of disposable sheets, either for free or for, let's say, 1 or 2 euros. And even some kind of blankets. But most of the blankets you do not want to use. Trust me. The advantage of a sleeping bag is that your entire body is covered. And you don't have to sleep directly on the bed. And in some cases, that's nice. Second thing is that you can put some of your valuables in your sleeping bag. And I never experienced it myself, but some people say that there are some people, or some pilgrims, or some so-called pilgrims cosplaying, who walk through their baggies and steal stuff from the pilgrims. I never experienced that, but could happen. They're the same people at the Albergis that you have at home. Kommen wir nun zu meinem No, English please. Now let's get to my sleeping bag. It's the Traveler Tree from Sea to Summit. And it's filled with specially treated down, highly compressible, only 446 grams, small size, and you can open that on the side, and if you have two of them, you can combine them as a double sleeping bag, or you can use it as a blanket when opening it. It's not that cheap. It was about, I don't know, 200 euros, but I have it now for about 6 years and I never regretted having bought it. Having bought it is correct, I think so. Now let's get to the cheaper alternative, the cotton sleeping bag. It's more or less a piece of, I don't know, bed sheet without any filling. Means no warming function, no insulation, no nothing. But it's cheap. It's only about, I don't know, 20 euros. But regarding that the temperatures in Spain, even in summer, can get lousy cold at night, and most of the albergues don't have any heating, I would not recommend that. And as you might see, from size here, it's almost the same size as my sleeping bag, and weight is only 10 grams less, so there's no advantage except the price. Now regarding the bigger mummy backpacks, Arctic proof with a hood. In general, they are cheaper, but they are much bigger. You cannot compress them as a small down backpack, sleeping bag. And yeah, you decide yourself. And I know there's many different brands, many different good sleeping bags, maybe cheaper, maybe better, I don't know. I don't care. Now to sum this up, do you need a sleeping bag? No. Would I recommend to buy one? Yup. Do you need a mummy sleeping bag? Arctic proof, no. And you know, I don't know if artificial material filling is better than down. I don't know. Mine is filled with down. And I think with artificial material and filling, maybe you sweat more. And maybe start smelling faster. I don't know. It's only prejudices. I don't know. At the end, it's all about your expectations about your sleeping comfort. And you have to take into account that sleeping at the albergue in general often not very easy. So you have to make your surroundings, you know what I mean, your conditions as comfortable as possible for you. And for that you need an appropriate sleeping bag. What appropriate means to you, you decide yourself. And yeah, I don't know if that was informative for you. I hope so. Next week, I don't know. I think about it. Till then, see you. Stay safe. Get out. Have a walk. And buon camino. Ciao, ciao.